So friends, when you decide to learn JavaScript, you should have some basic information and knowledge about the JavaScript, like what is JavaScript, how it works, where it is used, what we can do with it, etc. Let me share some basic and important information with you. JavaScript is trademark of Oracle Corporation in the United States. JavaScript is high-level, lightweight, and interpreted programming language for the web. JavaScript is most commonly used as a client-side scripting language. It runs to all modern browsers, devices, and operating systems. JavaScript can do calculation, validation, and manipulate data. The main benefit of JavaScript is that it requires less server interaction. You can validate the user input data before sending to the server. JavaScript has become one of the most popular programming language on the web. So what you will learn from this video? You can learn the basic syntax, variables, operators, data types, working with the dates, functions, how to use function, how to pass arguments, array, objects, events like onClick, onKeyPress, onKeyUp, then looping, for loop, while loop, do while loop, etc. Switch statements, working with forms, some bonus exercises, and some bonus projects. Let's start with the syntax. JavaScript has set of rules to how to code will be written, which is based on Java syntax. But Java and JavaScript are totally different. There is no other similarities between them. Example, as you can see, there is a script tag is open and script tag is closed. In between, our code will be there. You can place your script in any of the following location, like between the HTML documents head tags, between the HTML documents body tag, call as external file by using the JS extension file, variables. In JavaScript, variable can be defined as var, let, or const keywords. Variable generally used to store the data values. A variable with var keywords can be defined multiple times, but with let and const keyword we can't do it. I will explain you about this in next video. For now, just check the example with the different type of keywords like var, let, and const. Var abc. Here we have created a variable with the name of abc. Then let xyz. Same way, we have created a variable xyz by using let. Const x equal to 2. If you observe, we have assigned a value 2 to the variable x when using const. Because when we use the const keywords, we should have to assign the value at the time of initializer. So while we create a variable by using const keywords, we have to assign a value at initial time, otherwise it generates the error. Also, we cannot change the value of const variable once we assign it, except we assign array or object to the const variable. There are certain rules for variable constructing names. It means when we create a variable name, we have to take care of some basic rules, like name must begin with a letter, underscore, dollar sign, but not numbers. Names are case sensitive. Small a and capital are considered different variables. Name can contain letters, numbers, and underscore. No special characters like space, comma, quote, etc. allowed. Name should not be reserved keywords like case, else, false, catch, try, true, etc. Hope you understand about the basic rules of the variables creation. Okay, now let's start with some practice with the variable naming. As you learn, we can add the JavaScript code between the head tags, within the body tags, or user as an external file. So let's start with the script tag. Open it and close it. And we can do code here. So first, let's create a variable where a, b, c. Okay. Then let x, y, z. Let's check how it works with the browser. So to check the value in browser, we are using the method console dot log and pass the variable name a b c. Let's save it and check in our browser. I have opened Mozilla in my computer. Just right click and select inspect elements. You can find there is a console tab. Now you can see it prints undefined because we have not assigned any value to the variable abc. Let's try to assign some values. abc equal to 1 2 3 4 5 6. Save it and check the preview. Now you can see it prints 1 2 3 4 5 6, the value of the variable. Same way we can assign the value to the variable x y z. Here we are using a string, right? Now we are going to use console dot log and print x y z. Save and let's check preview. Fine, you can see it print welcome to learn and share. Let's create a variable by using keyword const x. For now we are not assigning any value and see it output. So again I am going to copy this line, paste, and call variable x. Now you can see it shows syntax error missing equal to in const declaration. So we have to assign a value first here equal to 5. Let's save and check it out. Okay, now you can see it shows the value 5 of the const variable. Now let's try to change the value of the x variable. Okay, x equal to 10. Just save it and check the preview. You can see it show type error, invalid argument to const x. So it means once we have assigned a value, we can't reassign or change the value. Just remove it and check it again. Now it's working fine. So friends, we learn how to declare the variable by using keywords where, let, and const. Hope you get the clear idea about the variable section. If you have still any question or confusion, feel free to message me through comment box. Now let's move with the rules of naming constructing. So first basic rule is name must begin with a letter, underscore, dollar sign, but not number. We have already created a variable with like a string. You can see abc, xyz, x. So let's check with other instance, like check with the numbers, where 1 2 3, and let's try to print and see what happened. Console dot log 1 2 3. You can see it's throw an error missing variable name. If we add any digit like this a and try to print, it's working fine. You can see it shows as undefined because we have not assigned any value. If we assign any value, it will show 10 as a result. Here it is. Now let's check with where dollar abc, console dot log abc.
Yeah, you can check it. So again, undefined. Let's assign a value right here and check it again. Yeah, you can see it show right there. Now let's test again with underscore where my where equal to everybody. Save and check it. You can see it's been everybody. Now let's try with some user keywords, like if you can see it's throw an error, syntax error, missing variable name. We can try one another, like case. Again, you can see it show syntax error. If I add or modify minor things like case zero, and assign a value, it should work. Yes, you can see. Now let's move with the case sensitive naming variables, like where a equal to first line, again where capital A equal to second line. Let's print A. What do you think? What it prints? First line or second line? Okay, let's check. We can see it's print first line because we have print small a. Let's print capital A. Now you can see it's print second line. I hope variable constructing names are also clear for you. Again, if you have any question or doubts, please message me through comment box. Okay friends, now let's move with next chapter, data types. JavaScript provides different type of data type to hold different types of value to variable. JavaScript is dynamic type language, so you don't need to specify the type of variable. It can hold any type of value like number, string, boolean, etc. There are mainly two types of data types are in JavaScript. First, primitive data type, and second, non-primitive data types. So what is primitive data type? Following types are considered primitive data types, like boolean, null, undefined, number, string. Hope you are aware about null, undefined, number and string because we have already used these in previous exercise. Second, non-primitive data types. Following types are considered non-primitive data types, like object or array. Let's check some example so you can get better idea about the primitive and non-primitive data types. Let's remove the old code and start with fresh one, where name equal to Chira Khatri. So this is a string type data type because we have assigned the value as a string type. Second one, where house number equal to 204. This is a number type data type. Third one, where is available equal to true. This is a boolean type data type. So when we create a boolean type data type,
there are only two values there, either true, either false. Another one, where x, y, z. Because we have already created a variable name without any value, it's called as undefined. Where a, b, c equal to null. Here we assign a value of a, b, c with null. Now let's check with the print each variable name. Log name. Let's save and check preview. You can see first string variable print Chirag Khatri, second house number is available true, XYZ as the undefined, and ABC null. Now let's create a non-primitive data type, and first one is object. So let's create a one object where personal info equal to, when we create an object, it store data in key and value format, like first name is a key and value will be name Chirag. Second value is separate with comma. Last name Khatri. Another one is available true. To get and print the value of the object is different than normal variable. So first we have to take the reference of the variable name and then its property, like console.log, like personal info dot first name. Let's save it and check it. Now you can see it's print Chirag. Let's print another value of the object, like is available, so true. So this is the method of the object and this is a method of normal variable. Now let's check with the second type is array. Where fruits equal to apple, sorry, in quotation, apple, banana, orange, kiwi. As you can see, it start with the square brackets and all values separate with the comma. Same way as a object. Again, here to print a value of the array is quite different than normal variable and objects. In array, each value stored in a particular sequence, like 0, 1, 2, and 3. So again, here to print the value of the array is quite different, like console.log. Here we have to use the name of variable, fruits, curly brackets, and position of the value, like 0. So it will print apple. Let's see. Okay, sorry. We have to remove this one. You can see apple. If I use second and say it's so 0, 1, 2 orange. So friends, we have checked primitive and non-primitive data types with proper examples. If you have any questions or query, please feel free to ask me through comment box. Now let's move with the next chapter, operators. JavaScript supports following operators, arithmetic operators, comparison operators, logical or relational operators, type of operators, assignment operators, conditional or ternary operators, arithmetic operators. JavaScript support following arithmetic operators which are used to perform on numbers. Here we are assuming that where a equal to 20 and b equal to 5. So operator addition will add the value a plus b and give the result 25. When use a subtraction, a minus b gives the result of 15. Multiplication, a multiply by b is give the result of 100. Division, a divided by b equal to 4. Modulus, a modulus by b equal to 0. Decrements, a minus minus. It means whatever the value have a, we decrease it by 1. Plus plus, increment. B plus plus. It means whatever the value b have, we increase by 1. Let's move with some examples. Again, let's clear the old code. Start with fresh one. Where number 1 equal to 20, where number 2 equal to 5. Now do with first one sum, where sum equal to number 1 plus number 2. Let's check the output. Console.log print sum. We can see the result is 25. Let's do with subtraction. Number 1 minus number 2. Again, print console.log subtraction. Let's give some proper title so it will help to understand the code. To concatenate, we have to use plus sign. If you observe, we have used plus sign here and here as well. So when we use the plus sign with any string, it JavaScript do concatenate with the string. But when we do plus sign with the numbers, it will do the calculation. Subtraction, where multi number 1 multiplication number 2 Let's do with another, where division number 1 divided by number 2 and again module for module we are using percentage sign here. Let's check this one. So you can see sum of number 1 and number 2 is 25. Subtraction number 1 from number 2, answer 15. Multiplication of number 1 and number 2 give us 100, and the multiplier 5. Division of number 1 number 2 is 4. Modulus of number 1 to number 2 is 0. Now use number 1 decrement.
where new number 1 equal to number 1. So we have assigned number 1 to new number 1. Console dot log new number 1. So it will decrease one value from the number 1. So you can see it show 90. Same way number 2 plus plus where new number 2 equal to number 2 console dot log new number 2 and check the result. So you can see it's increased 1 and the final value is 6.
Okay, another way is to deal with the same is like
number minus minus 10 console dot log number 1. Number 2 plus plus console dot log number 2.
It will give same result. Now you can see first time when we have decreased the value, it will give us the 90. And next time we have again decreased the value, so it will decrease from the main value, so it become a 18. Same way for number 2, we have increased and assigned here new number, so it become a 6. Again we have increased the value and it become a 7. So I have show you both the options how to deal with this. You can use as per your requirement and which method you feel easy for you. Now let's move with the next chapter, comparison operators. Comparison operators are used to test something which returns true or false on different scenarios. Here we are assuming that where A has a value of 20, B has a 5, X has a 10 and Y has a 10. So you can find there are different types of the operators and their description and examples. So let's check them one by one. Equal to, this operator compares two value and return the result. Example, A equal to B. It means it find that A and B has the same value. If they have same value, it return true as false. In our example, A has 20 and B has a 5 value. So it's return false. Three times equal size. It will check the value and type as well. So X triple equal to Y. It means X has a 10 and Y is also 10. And they both are in a numbers value. So the value and the type both are same. So it returns true. If we convert the value of Y in double quotation and make as a string, it will return the false because X is a digit and Y is equal string. Next, not equal to sign. Right? A not equal to Y. A is a 20 and Y is equal to 10. It means this is a true. A is a 20 and Y is a 10. So both are not equal to. Greater than sign. It means that X is greater than A. X has a 10 value and A is a 20. So X is not greater than A. So it returns false. Next operator is less than. Y less than B. Y has a 10 and B has a 5. So again this is a false condition because Y is 10 and B is a 5. Greater than or equal to. So in this scenario it checks the value is greater than or equal to comparison variable. Like X greater than equal to Y. X is a 10 and Y is equal to 10. So X is greater than equal to Y returns true. Less than or equal to. X is equal to 10 and A is equal to 20. X which has 10 value is less than equal to A. Means 20. In this situation X and A are not equal to, but X is less than A, so it returns true. Let's do some exercise so it gives you more idea about the comparison operators. It's so easy. So let's create a variable a and assign the value 10. Variable b, assign the value 20. Now let's start with the first operator equal to. Now you can see it prints false because a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20. So they both are not equal. Second one, console.log a 3 time equals sign and b. So this time it checks the value and type as well. So in this case result will be false. You can see if we change the value of b with the 10 and check and save, it will return true. You can see because a and b are 10 and they both are numbers, but if we add a quotation mark to the value b, so it becomes a string and this is a number. So in this case both are 10, a and b is a 10, but type is not same, so it will return false. Let's check it. We can see, let's remove it and assign another value 20. Now check it, another comparison operator, console.log a greater than b. So it will check that a is greater than b. So if yes, it will return true, else return false. In this scenario, a is less than b, so result will be false. You can check. But if we check that b is greater than a, the result will be true. You can see because b is greater than a. Same way we do check with less than sign. So here we are checking that b is less than a, yes or not. So result will be false because b is 20 and a is 10. So b is greater than a, not a less than. But if we use a less than b, a, b, the result will be true. We can check. Now check with not equal to, console.log a not equal to b. So it's checking a is not equal to b. A and b are different. A is a 10, a b is a 20, so they are not same. So in this scenario result will be true because they, because a and b are not same. You can check. But if we change the value of b with the 10, now both are same, so in this scenario result will be false. Now let's move with less than or equal to. Now a less than equal to b, so here we are checking that a is less than equal to b. So a is a 10 and b is also 10, so both are same, so equal to is satisfied in this situation. So result will be true. But if we change the value of a with lower side like a, in this scenario also result will be true because a is less than b. Let's check. Next one, console.log a greater than equal to, let's try with b, b greater than equal to a. So b is greater than a, it is not equal to a but greater than a, so result will be true. You can see. But if we change the value is 6, so b is not greater than or not equal to a, so in this situation result will be false. Okay, hope you are clear on the comparison operators. Now let's do some more exercise with using of string instead of the numbers, like where string 1 equal to hi. Where string 2 equal to no. Console dot log str 1 equal to str 2. So in this situation result will be false because string 1 is a high and string 2 is a no value. You can see no. If we can change string 2 value with high, result will be true. Okay, same way if we use not equal to, okay, so in this way string 1 and string 2 are not same. So result is false because both are same. But if we do minor changes to the any string, like adding extra character to the string 2 and check, it will return true. String 1 and string 2 are not equal or not same. So you can use all these operators with the numbers, and for the string you can use equal to and not equal to signs. Now let's move with the next chapter, logical operators. Logical operators are used to logically evaluate one or more expression and return a single value in boolean types or the other value which are evaluated to be a boolean type. JavaScript has mainly three logical operator, and, or, not. Let's assume a equal to 20, b equal to 5 and check some examples with the result. AND operator. A greater than 10 and b less than 5. So it will check both the operation and only return the true if both are the true. If any of the expression not satisfied, it return the false. In this example, a is greater than 10 but b is not less than 5 because b is 5, so it return false. Next operator is OR operation. It will check the both expression and return the true if any one of the condition is satisfied, like a greater than 10 or b greater than 10. So in this scenario a is greater than 10, a is a 20. But b is not greater than 10, b is a 5, so one condition is already satisfying here, so it returns true. Third one is NOT operator.
not operator perform not operation on its operand and return a boolean value either true or false. Like example, not a equal to b. In example, a has a value of 20 and b has a value of 5. Both are different, so it's return true. In JavaScript, if find following types of data, it automatically converts as a false, like a value of 0, null, undefined, empty or false. Let's do some exercise so it will give you clear idea about the logical operators. Let's clear previous sections and start with new one, where x equal to 20, where y equal to 15. Now first we are going to do some practice with the AND operators. You can see it's return true. We can also use the if statement to print the custom message, like if x greater than 10 and x less than 100, we can print yes, all is well. Let's save and check it out. Now you can see it show message yes, all is well. Now let's do some changes in the variable's value and check the result once again. Let's change the value of x is equal to 5 and check it out the result. You can see it shows the false but not the statement we mentioned in the if condition, because the code only executes when the both condition will satisfied. X is not greater than 10 but x is less than 100, only one condition is satisfied. Because we are using the AND operation, both condition needs to satisfy to show the custom message or perform the action. Let's do some changes in the code and x greater than 0 and y less than 50. Okay, and check it out this scenario. Now you can see it show yes, all is well, because x is 5 which is greater than 0 and y is less than 50, means y is a 15. Both conditions are satisfied and custom message is going to print. Now let's do another testing with the same operator. If x and y, it will print console.log x and y has some value. Let's save and check the result. You can see x and y has some value. As you can see, I have only used the variable name x and y to evaluate it and generate the result. So x and y has a some value, they are not null, that's why the code is executed and it's returned true. But if we use x is equal to 0 and save and check the result, as you can see it will not show any message because x is equal to 0. As we check out in the previous chapter, the value of the 0, null, undefined are considered as a false statement. So x is equal to false and y has some value, so it's written as true. So better understanding, I can just explain you how it's evaluated. If 0 and 15, x is equal to 0 and y equal to 15. As we learned in previous chapter, 0, undefined, null type data value are considered as a false statement. So x is equal to here false.
and y is equal to 2. But to perform the action, both condition needs to true because we are using AND operators. Hope this will clear you. Let's give you some more idea about the AND operators. And it returns true or false. Statement 1, true. Second statement, false. Return the false value. First statement, return true. And second statement, also return true. In this situation, it returned true. If first statement is false and second statement is also false, so it returned false. If first statement is false and second statement is true, it also return false. So as you can see, when both the situations are fulfilled, it's returned true. But any of the returns false, it always gives the result false. Now let's move with the OR operator. Console dot log x or y has y is greater than 10. X greater than 10 or y greater than 10. Let's save and check the result. You can see its result is true. If x is a 0 value but y has a 15, which is greater than 10. So one condition is already satisfied here. That's why it's written true. With the OR operators, there are only one condition need to satisfy to do operations. Let's change the value here with 7. So now there is no value is greater than 10. So in this situation, result will be false. Yes, you can see it's a false. Let's check some examples when OR operator returns true or false. Condition 1 equal to true or condition 2 equal to true. So in this situation it's written true. Condition 1 equal to false or condition 2 equal to true. So in this scenario, result is also true because one is already satisfied. Condition 1 equal to false, condition 2 also false. In this situation, result will be false. Condition 1 equal to true and condition 2 equal to false. In this situation, result will be also true because condition 1 is satisfied. I hope that AND operator and OR operator are now clear for you. Let's move with the NOT operator. Console dot log x is not equal to y, not x equal to y. Let's check the result. So x is not equal to y, true. because x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 7. Now let's change the value of x equal to 7 same as a y and check the result. Here it's written false. I know not operator may be little confusing for you, because using not operator it will convert a value to front as boolean true or false and return on opposite value, because here we are checking that x equal to y, which is yes 7 and 7, but we are using not operator is checking that value of x and value of y is not same, so this is a return false because they are same. Let's check with some more examples. We can use a not operator while assign a value like where a equal to not true. It means a is equal to false. Let's check the value of a. What is a? You can see it shows the false because we are using not operator. It means it's not true. Same way, where b equal to not null, so it will generate the result of true. Here we have created a variable b with not null value. So what is b? And print the b and we can show it so true. Hope no operator is also clear for you. Let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is assignment operators. The JavaScript assignment operators are used to assign the value to the variables. Here are the list of the operators with syntax and some examples. Let's check them one by one. First is basic operators, which is assigned by using the equal sign. We have created many variables in previous chapters, so you are much familiar with this operator, like a equal to 10. So here 10 is value assigned to variable a. Second one is addition operators, which is assigned with the plus equal to sign, like a plus equal to 10. So whatever the value a has, we increase more with the adding by 10. So it is similar to a equal to a plus 10. Subtraction operator, and it follow with the minus equal to sign. So a minus equal to 10. So it will decrease the 10 from the value of the a. It is similar to a equal to a minus 10. Multiplication operators, and follow with the multiplication equal to sign. A multiply equal to 10. So it means whatever the value a has right now, we multiply it by 10. It's similar to a equal to a multiply 10. Division operator, and it's followed by forward slash equal to sign. A forward slash equal to 10. So it is divide a value of a by 10. It is similar to a equal to a divide by 10. Remainder operators, it's followed by percentage equal to sign. A percentage equal to 10. So it's assign a remainder value to variable a. It is similar to a equal to a percentage 10. Let's do some practice so you will get more idea about the assignment operators. Let's first clear the old code and start with the fresh one, where a equal to 10 console dot log addition to a plus equal to 10. Let's save and check the result. Now you can see addition to a is equal to 20. So variable a is at value 10 and we are assigning 10 more, so it's become a 20. Console dot log subtraction to a by 5 a minus minus equal to 5, save and check the result. Now you can see result is 15. So at initial time when we create a variable a, assign a value of 10. After that we have increased the value by 10, so it become a 20, and after that we have decreased a 5 from the a, so it become a 15. Same way log multiplication to a by 2, a multiplication equal to 2, so it will give the result of 30. You can see it. Move ahead. Console dot log division to a by 5. A divide equal to 5. Save, preview. So you can see 30 divided by 5 equal to 6. Same way, console dot log reminder value of a any module equal to 2, save, check the result. Sorry, we missed the plus sign. Save. Now you can see the remainder value is 0. If we do minor changes here and save, we can get the remainder value 1.200082. I hope assignment operators are also clear too. If you have still any problem, query or question, please write me message through the comment box. Let's move with the next chapter. Let's first clear the old code and start with the fresh one, where a equal to 10, console dot log addition to a plus equal to 10. Let's save and check the result. Now you can see addition to a is equal to 20. So variable a is at value 10 and we are assigning 10 more, so it's become a 20. Console dot log subtraction to a by 5, a minus equal to 5, save and check the result. Now you can see result is 15. So at initial time when we create a variable a, assign a value of 10. After that we have increased the value by 10, so it become a 20, and after that we have decreased a 5 from the a, so it become a 15. Same way, log multiplication to a by 2, a multiplication equal to 2, so it will give the result of 30. You can see it. Move ahead. Console dot log division 2a by 5. A divide equal to 5. Save, preview. So you can see 30 divided by 5 equal to 6. Same way, console dot log reminder value of a any module equal to 2. Save, check the result. Sorry, we missed the plus sign. Save. Now you can see the remainder value is 0. If we do minor changes here and save, we can get the remainder value 1.200082. I hope assignment operators are also clear too. If you have still any problem, query or question, please write me message through the comment box. Let's move with the next chapter. Of conditional operators. Sometimes we need to perform action based on different conditions. To do that, we can use if statement and conditional operator question mark. The if statement evaluated a condition and returned the result to execute the code if certain condition met. Let's check with example where name equal to Chirag. By using the if statement, we have checked if name equal to Chirag, we show the message hi Chirag. If you want to execute more than one statement, you need to use curly brackets. Like if name equal to Chirag, we show the message alert hi Chirag. Again alert how are you today. In previous section, we see how if condition work with single condition. Now let's see how to work with the multiple condition by using as if clause. If is used to execute the code when certain condition is satisfied. As if used to use a new condition to check if the previous condition is not satisfied. Else is used to execute the code if none of conditions are satisfied. Let's check with example where name equal to Chirag. If name equal to Chirag, alert hi Chirag. Else if name equal to Deep, alert hi Deep. Else alert hey you are stranger. So first time if condition check the name with the Chirag. If we find the name is Chirag, so the message hi Chirag and rest of the code will be ignored. If name is not find as a Chirag, it check for the name Deep. If name Deep is find, it show message hi Deep. But again, if name is not Deep, so we are showing a general message, hey, you are stranger. We can use conditional operator to assign the value to variable based on a certain conditions by using shorthand code method. This operator is frequently used as a shortcut for the if statement. Sometimes we need to assign a value of the variable on certain condition, not the predefined. So on that situation, we use this method. The syntax is variable name equal to first part is condition, then we assign the value if it is true colon and the value if it is false. Like example where gender equal to male, we have to assign a salute by checking the gender. So if gender equal to male, we are assigned it Mr. as Miss. Let's check with one more example where age equal to 15 and we are going to show a custom message according to age. So if age greater than equal to 18, we show message you are adult as you are younger. Here you can observe that we are using the question mark and colon to assign the value. So question mark is mean the if condition, colon is mean else condition. So when first time condition is met, we assign the value, and if not met, then we have assigned another value. Let's do some exercise so you will get complete idea about the conditional operator. They are so easy. As usual, start with the fresh code, remove the old one. Where course equal to JavaScript, and let's print a custom message by using the if statement. If course equal to JavaScript, we show message alert, hey, you are learning JS. Just save and check the preview. You can see it's prompt a message, hey, you are learning JS. As we learned in previous chapter, to execute a single line code, we don't need any brackets. We can use if condition in a single line, or you can use a single line break. But we want to perform a multiple action, we have to use curly brackets. Now let's execute multiple statement with if condition by using curly brackets. So it will show you two alert box when run the program. Hey, you are learning JS. Hope you enjoying learn JavaScript. Now move ahead with some else statement. So we can keep this code and use another one, else if course equal to Python. We can execute another pop-up alert for learning Python, else alert course is not course is not identified. Just save and check the preview. First it's showing hey, you are learning JS, and second statement, hope you are enjoying to learn JavaScript. As you can see, rest of the code is not executed because condition satisfied at initial time in the if statement. Let's do change the name of course by Python, save and check the preview. You are learning Python. Okay, so course is not JavaScript, so this part is skipped and can't be executed. So next we check the course equal to Python. So yes, this is Python, so it's alert. So it shows the message, you are learning Python. Now we are using some another name, PHP. So in this scenario, course is not matched to if condition, not matched to else condition, so it will show us like a last else on statements message. The course is not identified. Just clear this code. Let's do an example with more validations. F age equal to 21. If age greater than equal to 21, we show message console.log, you are adult. Else if age greater than equal to 13 and age less than equal to 19, we show a message console.log, you are teenager. More conditions, else if age greater than equal to 10 and age less than equal to 12,
we print msa console dot log you are twin. More condition, else if age greater than equal to 6 and age less than equal to 9, we print a message console dot log you are child. One more condition, else if age greater than equal to 3 and age less than equal to 5, we print a message console dot log you are preschooler. Last one, else message console dot log you are too small.
So you can see we have checked the multiple conditions and show the message according to the our condition. If you observe, we have used logical operator and to check the condition and show the custom message on different scenarios. Let's save and check the preview. So it show you are adult because age is 21 and age fulfilled in first condition, age 21. Now let's change it with the 12. Save and check the preview. Now you can see it show you are twin. So it comes to the third one, age greater than equal to 10 and less than equal to 12. Now set the value of age 13. Now you can see message show you are teenager. Same way, we just change the value of age by 6 and message get changed with you are child, which is comes here. Now let's do with 5 and you can see it show you are preschooler here. If we have assigned value with 1 and say it so you are too small. Now let's check with the short code of if condition while create a variable and assign the value through if condition, where gender equal to girl, where color equal to, we check the gender and then assign the color value to variable color. Gender equal to girl, then we assign value pink as blue. Let's print the value of color. Save and check the preview. Color you like is pink because gender is girl. Let's change with the boy. Save and see the preview. Now it show color blue. So friends, I have tried to explain you everything with one of easy and useful example and hope that you get much idea about how to work with conditional operators. Let's move with next chapter. So friends, next chapter is functions. Function is a set of reusable code which can be called anywhere in your program. is designed to perform some specific task. When you have some common or repeat task to perform based on different inputs, we can use function. So you don't need to code multi-tier for same type of operation. Let's check the syntax of function. First, we have to use a keyword function which is reserved, and after that give the name of function. You can give any name of the function as you wish. In bracket, we can pass some parameters which are totally optional. Let's check with one example. In this example, we are doing calculation by passing two values. So function is keyword and do multiplication is a function name, and we pass arguments number 1 and number 2. And this function, we have created a variable name result, and we assign a result by multiplying the number 1 and number 2. And next statement is return result. So it's return the result to the parents where this function is called. And to call the function, we have used do multiplication and pass the value 15 and 4. So it will send the result by return statement, which will be 16. Let's do some more practice with the functions, so you will get more idea about the function and how it is useful. As usual, let's remove old code and start with the fresh one. Let's create a function. Function do sum, get the value of number 1, number 2, where do sum equal to number 1 plus number 2, return do sum. So it will take two value, number 1 and number 2, and do the sum and assign to the variable do sum, and whatever the value is do sum, it's returned to the parents. Let's call the function do sum 20 50. Just save and refresh. You can check it's not showing anything here because we have just called the function, but we have not printed it anywhere. So let's create a variable and assign the value to it, where my sum equal to, and print console.log sum is my sum. Let's save and check it out. Now you can see it gives us a result 70. The main benefit of function is you don't need to write each time the number 1, number 2 and sum for the result. You can just pass here like 10, 150, save and check the result. It's only 160. So you can perform the same type of operation multiple times by using the function. Let's create one more function with some complexity. Function and we give name is do calculation. Here we are passing two values, number 1, number 2 and operator. This time we make this function little bit advanced level compared to previous one. So here we are going to pass everything like plus, minus, multiplication to the function and do the operation. This time we are passing the operator as well to the function. So the calculation can be done through function. We don't need to create a separate function for multiplication, sum, division, etc. So first create a where my action equal to do calculation, number 1 is 10, second is 20, and here we are passing the plus sign. Let's rename the variable name with
to sum. Second one, do multiplication. Copy the same line. Pass the multiplication sign. Where do division. Paste the same. Change the value. Change the operator. First, we will check the operation and according to that, we generate the result. If operation equal to plus then return number 1 plus number 2. Else if operation operator equal to multiplication, we return result of multiplication. Again, else if operation equal to division, we send we return number 1 divided by number 2. If you observe, we have used comparison operator, arithmetic operators, conditional operators all in this function. Let's print console dot log sum is do sum division do division, save and let's check the result. Now you can see sum is 30. We have passed number 1 is 10 and number 2 is 20 and sign of plus. So it will sign of sum. So it generated result sum 30. Second variable, we have passed multiplication and numbers 10 and 20. So it's written a result 200. Same way, we have passed the value 50 and 10 for the division and we get the result of 5. If you don't want to assign a value to the any custom variable but print at the time of the function execute, you can directly call the function name do calculation 20 30, pass the operator. Let's remove this code. And instead of the use return, we can print console.log sum copy the same line paste here. Same way here as well. Let's save and check the preview. You can see it's print sum 30, multiplication 200, division 5 and sum 50, which is called through this function without variable name. So friends, I hope that you are clear on the function, how it works and how it is useful for your repeated tasks so easily. Let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is objects.
objects are used to store keyed collection of different types of data and more complex entities. An object is created with figure brackets, a data in key and value pair format. Let's go with very simple and easy example which give you more idea about it. Let's assume you have a nice car. So car is an object and its specification or details are called as its property. Let's create an object where my car and assign the properties like brand is BMW, color is orange, type is equal to sports. So as you can see, a single variable hold a multiple values with it. But how to call or use it? If you want to get a brand name, just create a variable where car brand or whatever name you want and just call the object with my car, use the dot and name the property of object like brand. Let's do some exercise so you will get real idea about how to deal with the objects. As usual, let's delete all the code and start with the fresh one. Create a object with keyword where my car and name equal to BMW, color black, type sports, cylinders, four numbers, so here we have created object my car and assigned multiple values to it. Now let's call one by one. My car name is reference of object name my car and the properties name. Save it and check the preview. You can see it's print my car name is BMW. Let's print another properties. Let's save and check. You can see it print name and color. Let's make this object more advanced by using multiple features like my new car, name BMW. What if we have one more property which have multiple sub properties like features? So we use square brackets and list down all separate by comma like airbag, passenger safety. Add one more properties like comfort and add multiple values like air conditioner, steering adjustment, and last one, climate control. So our object is my new car. We have assigned name, color, type and features. Features had with some more details. One more properties is comfort like air conditioner, steering adjustment, etc. Above we learn how to print a property of the each object. But to print the list of the features is totally different things. Let's print it the features one by one. Console.log feature 1. We have to take the reference of the variable name my new car, then features here we have the list of the features, so we can't use the dot. We have to use the position of the items like 0. So it will print features airbag. You can see it's print airbag. Features mentioned with the square bracket are start with the 0, 1 and 2 like an array. If we change the value with the 1, it shows the passenger safety. Same way, we can just copy, paste and print comfort details. Save, check the preview. So you can see first one is tiering adjustment. So friends, we have checked how to assign a multiple values to a variable by using the object. Let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is array. The array object allows you to store multiple values in a single variable. It stores similar pattern data within. Array store values in index basis which start with the 0. So here are the different types of the method of array and description. Let's check them one by one. First method is concat. Concat method is used to join two or more arrays and return the new array. It means when we join two different array, it will create a new set of the array, but original will keep as it is. Filter. Extract the element of the array that satisfies specific condition and give you a new set of result. It doesn't change the original. Find. Return the first element of the given array upon satisfy specific condition. Join. It returns the array elements in the string format. Length. Returns the total number of the elements in array. Pop. Remove last element of array and return the result. Shift. Remove the first element of array and return the result. Push. To add a new element to array at the end of the array. Reverse. It reverses the order of array elements. Slice. Select the part of array and return as a new set of array. Splice. Add or remove items from original array. Map. Create a new result array by calling a custom function on each item in the parent array. Friends, don't get confused about these methods. Array is so simple and so easy. As usual, let's move ahead and do some exercise so you will get more idea about the each method of array. Let's remove the old code and start with the fresh one, where fruits equal to, let's add some fruits name, apple, banana, orange, kiwi. So we have created a simple array by using square bracket. As we learn, each of the value is stored in an index method. So apple is in a 0, banana is a 1 position, orange in a 2nd position and kiwi is on a 3rd position. Let's print them one by one. Console.out. First element is fruits square bracket 0. Let's save and check the preview. You can see it's print apple. Just change the position with 2 and it will be print 0, 1, 2, orange. Here it is. Now let's move with the first method of concat. For that we are creating new array, more fruits equal to BlackBerry. Now we are going to add BlackBerry to fruits array. So console.log new list of fruits. Now you can see BlackBerry is added to the fruits array. Let's check with the filter. So for that we are going to create a new variable where numbers and assign some random numbers. Now what we will do is get the even numbers and odd numbers from this array by using the filter. So for that we are creating a variable odd numbers equal to array numbers dot filter, and we have to create a custom function to get the list of the odd numbers. So here we are going to give a name of function get odd numbers. Let's create a function get odd numbers. As array number is attached with the method filter, we can get the list of array by a parameter using any name numbers. So here we are going to return, as we done in previous chapter, numbers module by 2 equal to not equal to 0. Now save it. So basically our function will check the each numbers and find the odd numbers and return it to the variable odd numbers. That's print dot log odd numbers. Save it and check the preview. So you can see it's print odd numbers 45, 55, 89, and 99. Same way we can find the even numbers. Copy the function, paste it. Rename it even, and here we have to just change 0. Give the proper label odd numbers. Copy this, paste. Even numbers. Let's check the preview. You can see 12, 58, 78, 96, 44, each are printed here. So we get odd numbers, even numbers by using the filter. So friends, in this example we again use functions and use some arithmetic operators to generate the preview and do some operation.
Next method is find. Find method find the elements from the array and return the first element where condition is satisfied. Let's try with example. Find number 50. Here we are find the number which are greater than 50. Let's create a function. Return numbers greater than 50. And let's print the result through console. Let's save and check the result. Now you can find it's show the result 58, because when it checks 12 is not greater than 50, but 58 is greater than 50, so its result is 58. Friends, we can make the function inside the brackets like return numbers greater than 50, and we can remove it, so it will give the same result. Sorry, we can check. Okay, here we do some changes to check 100, so it will generate undefined because there is a no numbers greater than 100. We can check with 80. We can find it, so 96, which is here first one. Next method is join. Join is convert the array to string and print as a string, like console dot log string array with numbers dot join. Let's check the preview. You can see it prints the number as a string. Next one is length. Length is give us the total count of the array elements. Console dot tom total array number dot length. It's so there are 11 numbers in the array. Next method is pop. Pop will remove the last element from the array. So first we remove the elements by using the pop, and after that we can check the result. Array after pop. Let's save and check the preview. So you can see it's print till the 99 and 100 is removed. So pop will remove the last element from the array. So next one is shift, which will remove the first element of the array. It's opposite of pop. Array numbers dot shift. Let's copy this and paste for the result. Array after shift. Now you can see it's removed the 12 from the array. 58, 45, 78. Next method is push. Push is used to add an element to array at the last position. So we can add array numbers dot push new numbers, and after that check the new array. Let's say and check the preview. You can see 999 added to the end of the array elements. Next method is reverse. Reverse method is reverse the sequence of the array elements. So console.log reverse elements array numbers dot reverse. You can see it's reversed the sequence of the array elements. First was 999, after that 99, 89, and last one is 58. Let's commence this section so we can get the good space for the screen. Next method is slice. Slice is take a part of elements array and create a new set of array, like console.log. Here we are getting the first five elements of the array by using the slice. First five elements array numbers slice starting from 0 and five elements. Let's save, check the preview. So you can see we get 12, 58, 45, 78 and 96. These are the first five elements. While we are using the slice, it will not change the original array. It will just create a new set of the array. Let's check the original array. You can see original array is as it was with the all elements. Next method is splice. Splice is used to add and remove the elements from the array. Let's check with example. console.log remove elements splice. Let's first we remove the elements 45 and 78 from the original array. So 45 is on the position 2, and after that we want to remove two elements, so we have passed 2. So first is index and second is how many elements we need to remove. Let's save and check this part. Sorry, my mistake. Now you can see 45 and 78 is going to remove. Now we want to add few elements in the place of 45 and 78, like 200. Let's save. You can see there is no difference in the result because splice is only show how many elements and which elements are going to delete, but it's not show the result of the modified array. So we need to print original array by using console.log updated array array numbers. Now you can see that 12, 58 is there, 45 and 78 is removed, and in place it is added 200. The rest of elements are there. We can add multiple elements at the same time, like 200, 250, 300, 700, etc. Let's save, check the preview. You can see 200, 250, 300 are there. You may got a question, what if I don't want to remove any elements and add new elements at specific location? So here you have to just remove the number of elements need to remove and just save. So it will add 200, 250, 300 and 70 after the second, means from third position is 200, fourth is for 250, 300 and so on. Let's save and check the preview. So you can see after 58 it's added 200, 250, 300, 700 and 4570 is already there. I hope splice command is clear to you. Here again I am going to explain you the syntax. When we use a splice, first two arguments are used to remove the elements from the specific location and rest of will be added as a new elements. You can change the position like is a 5 as well, and it will add at the position of after 6. So you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 will be 200, 250 and rest of there. So with the splice method I show you two example to add the elements by removing or add the elements without removing any elements from the original array. Let's move with the next method is map. Map is generate a new set of the array by calling a custom method like where double val equal to array numbers dot map, and we can use custom function do double. So what we are going to do here is to get the numbers from the elements and double the value. Create a function do double, argument is number, going to return number multiply 2. Let's print the result. Double val. Let's save, check the preview. Sorry, spelling mistake. So you can see it's changed the value of the array elements by multiplying 2. Let's check original array here. So you can see original array is as it is, there is no change within. So friends, I hope you are also clear about the map method of the array. Now let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is date. The date object is used to get set date related data for your web page. You will get the day, month, year, hour, minutes, seconds, etc. details by using date object. Following are the constructor to be used to create a date object. You can create a date object by using simple keyword date without passing any parameters. You can use like date and pass the milliseconds as parameter. You can use the date by passing the parameters like year, month, day, hours, minutes, seconds, millisecond. You can use the keyword date and pass the date string. Date object also give us below useful methods which can display date in proper readable string like to date string, to time string, to local date string, to local string, to local time string, to UTC string. There are number of methods of the date object, but here we are going to check only some of useful methods like get date, which will return the day between 1 to 31 of the month according to local time. Get day return the day of the week between 0 to 6 of the week according to local time. Get full year return the current year of the local time, example 2019. Get hours return the value between 0 to 23 basis on local time. Get minutes return the value between 0 to 59 basis on local time. Get seconds return the value between 0 to 59 basis on local time. Get months return the value between 0 to 11 basis on local time. Set date to set the day of the month to a date object. Set full year to set the year of the date object. Set hour set the hour to the date object, where current date is equal to new date. Let's print console.log current date, current date, save. Now you can see it will print the whole t string like Monday, June 24, 2019, time zone and India standard time. Now let's move with some date methods. Let's print the current day of the month. console.log day of the month current date dot get date. So you can see it's print 24 because today is 24. I am going to write all the function here, so we will check the all result at once. I have write all useful methods of the date here, so we can check the preview with them. So you can see first get date, we already check it. So first get date, so it print as the 24 as current date. Second one, get day of the week by using get day, so it's print first because today is Monday and is a Monday is the first day of the week. Get year by using the get full years and it's print 2019. Current hours, it's print the current hours. Current minutes, it's print 15. Get seconds, current seconds, 43 seconds. And get month number, current get month number. If you notice, it's print the month number is 5 instead of 6 because date method returns the month information from 0 to 11. So that's why it's print the 5. And that's why it show the 5 because originally in the backend side is the position number of 6. So if you want to print the current month to anywhere in your project, you have to just add plus 1 within your code. Now you can see it's print 6. Let's check the set method. If you want to do some modification in your date, you can use the set method. Like I want to change the current month with the 10, so current date dot set month 10. So it will change the month of the current date and show the new date. Log date with new month date. Now you can see it set the month of November instead of June. We can also change the hours by using current date set hour, and we can set any hours like 6. Let's print the result. Sorry, my mistake. It's hours. Now you can see difference between the hours. We can also change the year 2020. Now you can see year is also changed by 2020. Let's write a useful methods which print the data in a proper readable format. I have write all the useful methods. Let's check the preview. You can see day string. Now it shows sort method of Monday, June 24 and 2019. Time string, current date to time string. So it will show only time data information there. Date string. So you can see it only print the date. To local string, it will print date, hours, minutes and AM, PM as well. Next one is to local time string. So it will return the time of the day with AM and PM to UTC string. So it will show the day string according to universal time. Next chapter is math. JavaScript math object provide several methods to perform mathematical operation. There are list of methods available, but here we are going to cover some of usual methods like below. One is absolute. It's written absolute value of the given numbers. Cell, round a number to its nearest upper integer. Example, 12.32 returns 13. Floor, round a number to its nearest downward integer. Example, 12.32 returns 12. Maximum, return the value of highest number from the given number list. As an example, we have passed 3, 8, 14. So it will return 14 as a highest number. Minimum, return the value of lowest number from the given number list. As an example, we have passed 4, 2, 5 and 7. So result will be 2. Power, return the value of the power. As per example, it will return 8. Random, returns the random number between the 0 and 1, but 1 is not included. So when we use this method, it will generate a random number between 0 to 1, like 0.1, 0.5, 0.03, etc. But 1 is not included. Round, round a number to nearest integer. Example, 23.50 will return 24. Let's check all this by example, so it will give you more idea about it. Let's start with the first one, absolute. Here we are passing negative values because absolute return the positive value. We can see it's return positive 15. If we remove the minus sign and check the preview, it will show the same result because it is already positive. Let me write down all the methods so we can check the preview for each one. I have write down all the methods, so let's go one by one. First one is cell. So we have passed 12.32. So return 30 because cell return the upper size of the given number. If we pass the only 12, the result will be 12 only. It will work properly when we have used decimals value with the number. Same way, let's check the floor number by passing 12.32. So you can see it's written 12 because floor return the nearest lower number. Even we increase the decimal value with the higher side like 99, it will return 12. As you can see, next one is maximum number. Here I have mentioned some numbers to get the maximum value from the list. 105 is the maximum number of the range, so it will return 105. Same way, let's find the minimum number from the range. So it will print 22. Now check the power. You can see its result 8. If we change the number with 2, it will give the result 4. It will change the both numbers 3 by 3. It will give 27. Next one is random number. Here we are generating number between 1 to 10. So you can see it generate 8. When we refresh, it generate 3. Again refresh, it generates 0. Again refresh, it generates 3. So each time when we refresh the screen, it will generate the new number between 1 to 10. Now as a basic syntax, if we don't use floor number and generate the random number, you can see it generates 0.40, 0.79, 0.69, 0.15, and so on. Next one is round. So we have passed 23.5. So it will round the numbers and give the result 24. If we change the value with 20, it will give the result 23. If the decimal number is greater than or equal to 50, it will increase the main value. So it will become a 24. So friends, I hope math chapter is clear to you. Here I like to create a small example with the random number. We already learned about the array. So just create a new array where numbers equal to, we can also create an array by using the keywords new array and pass the value 10, 25, 87, 86, any random number. Now you know that by using the len method, we will get the total number of the elements from the array. So here we are going to use it to generate the random number from the range. So where numbers length equal to numbers dot length. Now we are generating a random number between the array length. So where number equal to match dot floor match dot random and using the array length. So first let's check the random number generated by the function. So it generated number 4, 7, 2. Let's also print the length of the array. We'll get the idea that generated random number is not greater than length of the array. So generated number is 7 and our length is 8. So generated number is under the our length 08 28 48. Now by using the generated number, we will print the number from the array. Random array value is, to print the element from the array, we have to use int variable name numbers and from the bracket, and within a bracket we have to pass the position of the array. So here we are passing the random number. Let's save, check the preview. You can see it generated a 0 and from the 0 position we have the value 10. Is generated number 2 and from number position 0, 1 and 2 as a 87. Again 4 and 4 position is 25. So here you can pass anything other than numbers like fruits name, apple, banana. Just save, check the preview. So random number is generated 0, and 0 position is for apple. Refresh the page. It generated one number and one is for banana. Again generator number 3, which is for kiwi. Again 3, again 0. So friends, with this example you better know about how to deal with the random number in your project. Let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is statements. JavaScript statements are used to give an instruction to the browser to do action when certain conditions fulfillment or not. So we can also say that statements control the program flow. Here are the sum of statements and the description. If, else, else, if. Now you are aware about the if statements because we did many practice in previous chapters. So it executes the code section upon certain conditions. If condition true, it executes the code. If condition is not true, check for another condition to check. Switch execute the code from multiple expressions. It's work similar to if else, but it is ideal to use when long nested statement needs to be checked. For statement code of blocks to be executed for the fixed number of times repeatedly until some condition is satisfied. While code of block to be executed until the condition is satisfied. Do while code of the block to be executed at least one whether condition is satisfied or not. Return stop the execution of operation and return the result from function. You are also aware about this. Function used to perform an operation can also use multiple times to save the times. You are also aware about the function very well. Let's do some exercise for each statement as usual. Let's remove the old code and start with the if conditions. We have already do some exercise with the if condition. So I am taking the same example here for revision and reference. Here we have created a variable age and assigned the value 21 and check if age greater than or equal to 21, we are going to print you are adult. Else if age greater than or equal to 13 and age less than or equal to 19, we are going to print you are teenager. Else if age greater than or equal to 10 and age less than or equal to 12, we are going to print you are twin. Else if age greater than or equal to 6 and age less than or equal to 9, we are going to print you are child. Else if age greater than or equal to 3 and age less than or equal to 5, we are going to print you are preschooler. Else we are going to print you are too small. Let's save and check the preview. Let's print you are adult. If we change the value 12, it's print you are twin because the condition is fulfillment here. If we set age 9, it will print you are child. If we change it to 2, it will print you are too small. Now let's move with the next statement, switch statement. For that, I am going to remove everything again and create a rating system where rating equal to 5, switch, pass the rating, so case 5, we are going to print excellent service and break. So it will stop the execution of the rest of part. Let's copy and paste for multiple times. 4, 3, 2, 1 and default. So in case rating is not set or no value is provided, it will show default message. So 5 is for excellent, 4 is best, 3 is good. Sorry, no need to use case here, default. Now as we have set the rating 5, it show message excellent service. Let's check with 4, it show best. With 3, it will print good service. With 2, somewhat not satisfied. With 1, poor service. And if 0, no rating provided. Even if we return assign any value, it will show same, no rating provided. So friends, hope C statement is also clear to you. Let's move with the next statement, for loop. So here let's clear the code. For statement we have to use syntax for initial value where I equal to 0 and set the maximum limit I less than equal to 10 and increment by 1 each time. So I plus plus. Friends, here we are using arithmetic operator plus plus, which increase the value of variable. So here what will happen, for loop is execute the code 10 times because we have set the maximum limit of 10, and each time after execution of the code it will increase the value of I by 1. So start with the simple example. We will print the hello world 10 times. console.log hello world. And let's print the I in front of the text so it looks proper. Let's save and check the preview. So you can check hello world is print 11 times because where initial value is 0. Either we can use I equal to 1 or remove the equal sign from condition, so it will print 10 times. Here it is start with the 0 and 9, so we can do I plus 1 and save, so it will show the proper result. So one hello world, second hello world, three till 10 hello words. This is a very simple example. In past chapter we also learn about the array, so we can use array here again for better understanding on proper example. So let's where fruits equal to new array. Now what we are going to do is print all the fruits name in a sequence. So for that, where I equal to 0 as it is, I less than, here we are using the length of the fruits, fruits dot length and I plus plus. Let's print all fruits name. Console dot log fruits bracket and pass the value of I. For loop execute the code until it reaches the end of the fruits array. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it's print banana, kiwi, mango, orange and apple. Let's do one more exercise with the array of multiple values, like where students equal to square bracket against square bracket John, roll number 25, and division F. Just copy and F division let's take the reference of students. Elements based on the position, just 0 for the name, 1 for the roll number, and 2 for the division. So students zero is for name, so let's print give title name concatenate string roll number students I 1 let's concatenate print a division students I and 2 let's save and check the preview. Now you can see name is equal to John, roll number 25 and division. So all data prints by using the for loop. So friends, here I tried to explain the for loop with a single dimensional array and multi-dimensional array. Now let's move with the while statement. I'm going to remove the for loop and keep the variable's name as it is, so we can use it for the while statement. For while statement, we are going to create an initial variable where I equal to 0 while I less than fruits dot length. Let's print console dot log fruit. For while statement, we have to increment the value of I manually. So I plus plus. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it's print banana, kiwi, mango, orange, and apple. So friends, the main important part of the while loop is increment the value. If you forget this, this loop never ends and it will crash your browser. So don't forget to increment the value. Same way we can use student data. Let's say students 0 here we are going to only print student name because you better know how to print other elements. So let's save check the preview. So you can see it's print all the student names John, Mary, Robert, Anil and Don. So friends, I hope you are clear on for statement and while statement. Let's move with the next one, do while. For do while, we are going to remove this one and use another example where number equal to 1. Let's start with do. So in do statement, program is executed first and after that check the validations. So console.log value is number increment the number value, right? While here we have to put the condition number less than 10. So what we are going to do with the do while statement, it's print to print a number till 9, not the 10, because we are using less than 10, not less than equal to 10. So let's save and check the preview. As you can see, value 1, 2, 3, 4 till 9. As we learn, do while statement execute at least one time whether condition is satisfied or not. So if we remove the 0 and put only 1, so number less than 1 is not satisfying here, because number is equal to 1, not less than 1. So let's save and check the preview. So here you can see it's print at least one time. So friends, hope you are clear about the do while as well. Now let's move with the return and functions. So delete this one. You already know about the return and function, but again here let's do some exercise. Function return message, and here pass star. Let's call the function by passing some values. Return message 5, where message equal to blank, star equal to 5, message equal to excellent service. Let's copy. If 4, 3 not star, else if let's change the message. Let's remove this part because it is already in the last validation, and at last we have to return message. Let's store the message in a variable, user rating equal to rating message, and print user rating. Let's save, check the preview. Now you can see excellent service. Let's pass 3. It's so good service. Okay, let's do something here. console.log a im within function, save and check the preview. As you can see, it's show message unreachable code after return statement, because we are returning the message to return statement. So after the return statement, no code will be executed. If we comment the return statement and save, it only show hey, I am within a function. Now you can see hey, I am within function. But as we are not returning anything, the console user rating is showing undefined. So return message will pass the message, but after the return statement, no code will be executed. So let's save, check the preview. Again, good service. If we want pass anything, is written no rating provided. So friends, with this example, we have covered function and return statement as well. So hope you are also clear about this. Let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is events. Event is most frequently used to browser for various purpose. When user click on button, type something within input box, submit the form, etc. need to use event to perform the action. In HTML body load is also event which perform when web page loads. Here are some most common and frequently used events. First one is on click. Event fire when user click on HTML element. On change. Event fire when HTML element change. On mouse over. Event fire when cursor means mouse pointer move over an element. On mouse out. Event fire when cursor means mouse pointer leave an element. On load. Event fire when the document loads. On key down. Event fire when key press from keyboard. On key press. Event fire when key press from the keyboard and release. Here event can't fire if press escape, alter, shift, etc key. On key up. Event fire when key release. On blur. Event fire when focus loss from element. On focus. Event fire when element gets focus. Let's do some exercise for all event so you will get more idea about the events. So as usual, let's remove the old code and start with fresh one. As we are working with the events, we will use some HTML elements to perform the actions. So let's start with the on load. So on load event generally fire within a body tag. So when web page is load, event is fire. So let's use on load and call a function, say hi let's add some dummy text. So let's create a function, say hi. You better know how to create a function with the keyword function, function name. Here we are using alert to show the message. Hi there. Let's save and check the preview of first event. Now you can see it's prompt the message hi there. Let's move with the next one is on click. Let's do some formatting so our web page looks better. All the details div container. Let's save and check. It looks better with the custom font. Now let's create a anchor tag, a href. And attach event on click equal to click event. Label click me for magic. Let's create a function click event. So the message, hey you click me. Just save and check the preview. You can see it's create hyperlink. Let's click and you can see hey you click me, it fire and events. Let's remove on load so each time it will not prompt the alert message. Now let's do some real magic with the on click event.
what we are going to do is when user click on the link, click me for the magic, we will change the color of the text with new color every time. So for that, let's create a variable I equal to 0. And here we have passed the element as a reference, so we can call it as an object. You can assign any name for the parameters you want. I am just using object, so it's better to understand. Now let's use switch statement here, so it will cover the previous chapter as well here. So switch I case 0 object, it means the anchor tag dot style dot color equal to red. When click on the anchor tag, it will come to the function. First time value of the I will be 0, so it will apply the color by using the style tag and color will be red. Let's break. Here we need to increment the value of I plus plus. So next time when user click on the link again, we will get the updated value. Let's copy the code and paste for multiple times, like for 1 green, for 2 is equal to blue, for 3 it will be orange, for 4 it will be purple, and last one is default. Color equal to black. So in any case, if error is there, it will show the black color. Let's save, check the preview. Now first time I will click and color change to red. Now do click again. Now you can see color is not going to change because variable I is declared within a function. So each time I value will be 0. So we have to create a variable outside of the function. So it will override with our function. Let's save and check the preview. Now it's red, it's green, it's blue, it's orange, it's purple, and last it's black. Now we click more, but the color is not going to change because value of I is increasing more and more each time. It will not cover to any case. So here we make a validation that if I greater than equal to 5, because we have only 5 colors there, we will make I equal to 0. This is a short condition. You can see we have used also if statement here. Now let's save and check the preview. Click red, green, blue, orange, purple, again red, green, blue. Now you can see the color is changed each time because when the value of I reach to the 5, we are reset the value with the 0, so it will cover in the our switch statement and change the color. Let's move with the mouse over on mouse over. We can use same function with for the mouse over as well, because we can use custom function for the event. So we can use any function for any events. So let's save and check the preview. Again, when we hover, it will change the color. Here we are not going to click on the link, but when we mouse over, it will change the color. We can use say hi and change the message. You mouse over to me, and let's use this function instead. Here we don't need to pass this because we are not using object for any operation. So let's remove, save. Now you can see you mouse over to me, it show custom message. Same way, we use mouse out. So we are using same function, just change the message. You leave mouse from me. So when we hover, it will not show any message, but as we leave, but as cursor out from the link, it will show alert message, you leave mouse from me. You can see you leave mouse from me. On over, nothing will be happen, but when leave the mouse, it show the custom message. Next one is on blur. For on blur, it's better we can use input type equal to text name, text name, give any name, value will be blank. So first time it will be blank, and we can use a property placeholder your name here. Let's save, check the preview. Now you can see it show your name here. Let's make it in separate line. Now it looks good. On blur equal to say hi. Let's save and check the preview. My name is Chirag, and when we use the tab or leave the cursor, it show you leave mouse from me. So we can use proper message here. You left input box. Let's save and check the preview. You can see you left input box. Let's do some additions and pass this, so we can access all the properties of input to the say hi hello function. Here we can use as an object custom message by using the name of user enter by him. So alert hi concatenate and get the name from the input by using object and property is value. Now concat and rest of message. Hope you are doing fail. Let's save and check the preview. Chirag. Now you can see, hi Chirag, hope you are doing well. It show custom message. Now let's move with the next one is on focus. Let's keep this one and create new one and on focus and call a custom function give hint. Here we don't need to pass the object here, so I am going to remove it. Name is text hint. Here we are not using placeholder. And friends, when you create any HTML elements, just make a habit to keep the proper naming conversion. Like for text, use prefix txt and first one capitalize for the name. This is not necessary, but this is for the good habit, so your code looks proper and easy to understand. Let's create give hint. Create a function give hint. So when cursor comes to the input, we give the hint what customer need to type there. Alert, enter your last name. Let's save and check the preview. Okay, here Chirag, we have used tab and it show message, hi Chirag, hope you are doing well. Okay, now it show the next message, enter your last name, because when we use the tab, cursor automatically move to the next HTML elements. So here second text box got the focus and our event fire through the function, so it show enter your last name. Say okay. Khatri, we have used tab and nothing will happen, but when each time cursor come to this text box, it show the message. Let's click here and you can see enter your last name. Now let's move with the next one is on change. Let me remove some code so we will get more space for further example. Let's remove this. For on change, we are using another HTML element, select name equal to select color and attach events on change equal to change color. And here we are passing the object to get the value of the select element. Select create option value will be red. Label it red. Just copy to paste and black. Same, we have to change the value. Blue. First, let me show how it looks on the browser. So you can see it show a drop down of the colors. So you have to select anyone to perform the action. So let's create a function change color. Function change color and select, just we have used select keywords for the object. Let's first check the value selected by user. So alert sale dot value, just save and check the preview. It's blue. it's orange, it's black. Let's expand the function and do something more with it. So for that we are using another p tag and message your favorite color is here. We are using span and keep it blank, or we can print default red color, give the ID. So we can change the text through custom function id color selected. Now let's capitalize the value so it will looks proper. And copy the ID of the span tag and let's use here like document get element by ID. We have to pass the ID here dot, and for the text we have to use inner HTML equal to selected dot value. Let's save and check the preview. First, by default we have print red color as first one is red. Now let's change green, so it change green, it's orange. Let's add some more code, like copy the same and change the color of the text by using style tag style dot color and select value. Let's save and let's check the preview. So you can see blue, green, black, red. So text color is also going to change. So you can expand your function according to requirement or more complex way you like. Next, three events like on key down, on key press and on key up generally used within input text. So let's remove the unnecessary code and check with the key events. Here we are using on key down and use the same function give hint. Let's save and check the preview. I am going to type something for the input. As you start to press on a keyboard, it will show you message. Okay, first is H, again I, it show enter your last name. So on key down it call the function each time when we press the key from the keyboard. Same way on key press, let's use the same function. Hi, tell. So you can see it call the custom function on key press each time. But if I press the escape key, nothing is happen. If I press tab key, nothing is happen. If I press shift key, nothing is happen. Let's move it on key up. Let's change the message. You up the key. Let's save and check the preview. You can see it first print the text and after that show the message, while on key down and key press it show the message first and after that it print the text. Let's print I. You can see I is there and after that message is showing. Generally on key down, on key press, on key up is used when we need to validate the input from the user. So we can stop him if we find any errors or problem with the input. Let's move with the next chapter. Next chapter is DOM, Document Object Model. With the HTML DOM, JavaScript access all elements of HTML and change it as per requirement. The document object represent whole HTML document. By using document object, we can control the document elements. The properties of document object that can be controlled or accessible by document objects are anchor, form, links, text box, text area, checkbox, radio button, select dropdown, buttons, etc. JavaScript can change the element of the page, change HTML element and attribute, add or remove HTML elements, change CSS style of elements, write the string to the document, get the element by properties like ID, tag name, class name. Document.getElement by ID. To access the HTML element by attribute ID, this method is used. Document.getElements by class name. To access the HTML element by attribute class, this method is used. Document.getElements by tag name. To access the HTML elements by tag name, this method is used. Document.createElement. To create a new HTML element, this method is use. Element.createTextNode. To create a new HTML element, you should first create a node. Element.innerHTML. To access and change the content of HTML element, this method is use. Element.style.property. To change the style of the element, this method is use. We have already used getElementById. .innerHTML and style property in our examples. Element.setAttribute. To change the attribute of HTML element, this method is used. AddEventListener. To add an event to element like click, on mouse over, etc. Window.innerHeight and window.innerWidth. To get the height and width of the browser window, this method is used. But here you have to keep in mind this property not include the toolbar and scrollbar size. Window.open. To open a new window, this method is used. Window.close. To close the current window, this method is used. Window.locationhref. To get the current window's URL, this method is used. Window.location.hostname. To get the domain name of the web host, this method is used. History.back. To load previous URL in the history, this method is used. It works same way as back button work on browser. History.forward. To load the next URL in the browser, this method is used. It works same way as forward button work on browser. Alert. Alert method generally used when we want to show some message when information comes from user. We have already used alert method for our exercises. Confirm. Confirm use when need to confirmation from user to accept the rules. Prompt. Prompt is used when need to value from the user to input before perform the action. Let's check some example for all DOM so you will get more idea about how to work with DOM and how you use for your project. So as usual, let's first remove old code and start with fresh one. Let's create a div and give a ID and call is a para section. Because we are going to create paragraphs here, so this is first paragraph. Again, let's create a paragraph outside the para section div. So here we are going to create a button and attach event on click equal to find elements and label find paragraphs. So when click on this button, we will get the details of paragraphs by using DOM. So let's first create a function let's create a variable paras and fetch the paragraph details by using DOM document dot get element by class name, and we have give class name para. So friends, when we use get element by class name, it will give the result as a array. You better know how to get the length of the array. So let's use alert and paras dot length. So this is the alert box which shows how many paragraphs are there which has class para. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it show total paras 5. So first, second, third, fourth and 5. We have 5 paragraphs. Friends, you also know how to print the elements of the array by using the position number like 0. So it will show the paragraph 0 as a object. Let's save and show you how it looks. You can see it's print as an object HTML paragraphs elements. We have two different properties of the paragraph to fetch the details or information like dot inner HTML is used to get the content of the paragraph. So it will show us the message. This is the first paragraph in the pop-up. Let's remove this one and only print the content. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it's print only. This is the first paragraph. You can change the number and check the result. This is the fourth paragraph. You can also get the property details like class name. So it will show us the result as a para because we have assigned a class para. So let's save and you can see it shows us para. So by using the DOM, we can read the details of the HTML elements and change as well. Let's change the text of the any paragraph by using inner HTML. So paras 3 dot inner HTML equal to this is custom text from function. Let's save and check the preview. So it will remove the fourth, this is fourth paragraph, and replace with the custom text. This is a custom text from function. You can see this is a custom text from the function. So by using the DOM, you can control all HTML elements. Let's try to remove first paragraph. Paras 0 dot remove. Let's comment this code, just save and check the preview. Let's click on find paragraph. You can see first paragraph has been removed. Now create a new button. This time we are going to create an element when we click on the button. So new element. Create a new button. and let's create a new paragraph where we will include the button through custom code. ID equal to new para. So first let's create a function new element where button equal to document dot create element, or let's give it name button because we are going to create a button. Then by taking the reference of button dot inner HTML, we are going to assign a label I am a new button. Okay, now here we have created a button, but we have to add this button to our web page. So let's add by using document dot get element by id new para dot append child, and what we are going to append is btn, means new button. So first we have created a variable button, and by using the DOM we have created a element button, and by taking the reference of the variable button we have assigned a label I am a new button. Now we have to print a button to our new paragraph named new para. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see this is a create a new button. Let's click it again. So as many times you click on the button, it will create a new button through the function. Let's create a new text element. So for that, just copy the code. Text. Just function new text. Let's use the confirm method as well. When user click on a button, we show a confirmation box that do you want to create a new text element. If we click on the yes button, only that time we create a text button, as we do nothing. So for that we are using if condition confirm and message are you sure to create a new text element. So when the confirmation box appears to the user and he click on OK, only that time our code will be executed. So last year we have created a new variable where new tag equal to document create element. Let's create h1. For text type element we need to create two elements. First is for the element and second for the text. So let's here we use prompt, so user can input the text he want to display on the screen instead of the fix. So prompt and enter the text. Okay, now let's combine tag and text together where text tag equal to new tag dot append child new text. So what this code will be do is like append a child new text to the parent tag new tag. So user enter text will be assigned to the h1 tag. Now let's print the h1 tag to the document. So document dot get element by id dot append child and use text tag. Let's save and check the preview. Let's click on create a new text. So here it is confirming that are you sure to create a new text element? OK and cancel. If we click on OK, it will go to the our condition and ask for the text. But if we use cancel, it won't do anything. Now let's click on OK and create a text node. This is my first custom text. Now click on OK. You can see this is my first custom text. So let's recap the function once again. So first we are going to confirm with the user that are you sure to create a new text element. If he click on the OK, first we create an element like h1. After that we have to assign a text, so we are using the prompt method and asking for the text from the user sides. Once user has entered a text, we are going to create a text node and assign the text to it. Now we have created an element and created a text node. We have to combine them and show to the web page. So first we have append tag and text together, so the code is not going to much complicated. And after that, using the id of new para, we append the child text tag there into the our web page. Friends, we can also change the color of the paragraph by using style properties. document.getStyle.color equal to blue. Let's save and check the preview. Create a text node. Hello world. Now you can see it's printed text in a blue color. We can also change the formatting by using the set attribute. So let's copy, paste and comment this one and use set attribute . We are going to assign a class and let's create read text. Let's save and check the preview. Now create a . Now you can see it simply print the hi there without any formatting because we only assigned the class name but didn't create any class. Let me show you in the preview. Now you can see class readText is already there. Let's create a CSS for that. I know this is not a part of our exercise, but just want to give you some idea about how it works. So let's create a style text and we can use font family Arial, font size 18 pixel, color blue. Let's save and check the preview. You can see it's in a blue text and font size is little bigger than others. We can also use more bigger 24 and use red color. Now you can see it show a little bigger fonts and in red color. Now let's move with the window object. So for that as usual, let's clean the old code. Friends, window method is represent the open window in browser and it supports to all browser. So we can access the property of browsers for different purpose and use in our project. Let's start with the some properties like inner height, width, location, name. So console.log window.location let's save and check the result. Now you can see it show the path of the file. Now let's print another one, window hostname. Now currently we are working in a local computer, so it's so undefined, but when you run this code in your website, it will show you the domain name of your website like www.google.com, www.yahoo.com, etc. Now find the height and width of the window. Window dot inner height, same way, just copy. Let's check the preview. Now you can see it show height 298 and width 650. So it will show the height and width of the browser, but it will not calculate the height of the menu bar and status bar, everything. It just calculate the plain window's height and width. Now let's create a HTML element paragraph and create a button to open a window and click open new window. Let's give a label open a window and let's create a function open window. Window dot open. Here we can assign a URL of the window, or we can keep it blank if we open to our custom blank window. Let's create a Google any window. Let's save and check it out. Now you can see it's open a Google. Let's close it. And we open our custom window with our custom text. So let's leave it blank. Give the name my custom window. We have to create a variable inside, like variable my window equal to window dot open custom window and my window dot document dot write. Document dot write is used to print something on the browser. So let's add some text. This is my first window. Let's see how it looks. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it's open a new blank window and print our message. This is my first window. Let's see how it looks. Now create another button to close the open window. So close new window, close window. To close a window, we have to use the reference of the window object. But as you can see, we have created an object variable within an open window, so it is not accessible in the close window function. So let's make this variable global. So we just put outside of the function and remove the where from here. Now in this way, this variable is global and we can access through any, and we can access from any function. So let's use it to close the window. So my window dot close. Let's save and check the preview. Open window. Now close. You can see it's close. Let's add some extra specification, like width equal to 200, height equal to 200, and top position equal to 50. Let's save, check the preview. Now you can see it's open a pop-up window with "this is my first window", and when we click on the close window, it will close this. Let's increase the width. Now you can see size is increased. Now let's click on close button, so it will close it. Let's try to put the button close window inside the window. So here we are going to go right, "this is my window", add some more text. Button on click equal to close window dot close. Let's save and check the preview. Open window. Now you can see close button is there. Let's click on close. You can see it close. So friends, I hope you are clear about the window object, and now you are able to use properly in your web page. Now with this exercise, our JavaScript course is complete. Let's create a small project by using the JavaScript functions, methods, loop, everything which we already learned. So it will give you more idea about how to deal with the JavaScript in real web pages. So get ready for the next exercise. So friend, let's make a to-do application in JavaScript. So it will work like learn JavaScript, practice JavaScript, do more practice, try to implement in project, do testing of project before deliver. Now you can see it's add all the to-do items. We can mark it as a done or remove as well. So let's learn JavaScript, mark as a done. If we make it mark as a done by mistakenly, we can mark as a pending. So it's come to the pending. Let's mark as done, and we can also remove it. Same way, practice the JavaScript, mark done and remove. Let's mark the done last one and remove it. We can remove it, and at last we are showing no items found. So this is a simple to-do list application which we are going to make in a JavaScript. So let's move with the code part. As usual, let's remove the old codes. First, let's make a HTML form to get the input from the user. Method equal to post action equal to blank, because we are not passing the data to some other page or server. Then on submit, let's create a function and return something. So return add to do and pass form as a object. Now let's create a input type equal to text. Give ID text to do, name equal to text to do. We can set the size equal to 50. We can also set maximum length equal to 15. This is optional and not compulsory. The reason of using the maximum length is that user can't put the text more than 50 text. And we can use a property place holder, which will give a hint to the user what he need to type there. So we can add new to do item. Now let's create a button and set type equal to submit and give the title add. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it show a text box and button to add. So let's do some formatting and make the form proper so it looks good for the user. So first let's add some style to input tag, like font family, give some font size, some padding 5 pixel is from top side, top and bottom size, and next one is 8 pixel. So it will add top and bottom side 5 pixel padding, left and right side it add 8 pixel padding. Let's give some nice border. So border 1 pixel. Border type is solid and give the color CCC, little lighter, and give some border radius 8 pixel. So text box looks in round shape. Let's save and check this. Now you can see it looks better. Now do some formatting with the button add. Again font, save and check the preview. Now you can see it looks better. Now let's make a function add to do list, so we can save the to do item. So for that, so create a function. We can name it as a form. So friend, to save the to do, we are using array object. So when user add a new to do item, we will store in the array object. So let's create where to do list and as a blank. Now create a variable to get the value of the input box. So where to do is equal to reference of the object form, and text field name is txt to do. Now first we will check whether user has input anything or hit the button without adding any item. So we will show the proper message. So first, if to do dot value not equal to blank, we will store in the array, else we will show a custom message alert to do item should not be blank. After that we will stop the execution, so use return false, because here there is an error and we can't process with the error. So in the case when user have entered a to do item, we can add it to array by using the method of push. So to do list dot push, here we are going to add a to do item with two properties. One is like a title and assign the value of to do item. So to do value. Next one is status. So for now, when first time user create a to do item, we have set is a like a pending and set with the one. So one means pending and zero means completed. So first time it will be a pending. Not save and check the preview. Let's first try to click on add button without adding anything. So it shows message to do item should not be blank. Let's add my first. Now click on add. As you can see, when we click on the add button, is submit the form and refresh the page again. So we have to use return false here as well, because we are not sending any data to any page. So return false will keep the windows open and not refresh. So all data will be there. Let's add a custom message to do item has been added. So it will notify a user that item has been added. Let's save and check the preview. Here is my first to do item. Let's click on add. You can see to do item has been added. Okay. But you can see this text is already there. So to add a new to-do item, user needs to remove this and add new one, another. So what we will do is, once to-do item is added, we will clear the text box and set the focus there. To-do dot value equal to blank. So here we are reset the value of the text input and to do dot focus and set focus to input once again. Let's save and check the preview. First to do item. You can also use the enter to save the to do item. Now you can see to do item has been added. Now you can see text input is also blank and cursor is already there. So we can add second to do item. Let's hit enter. It is added again. Now next step is we have to show to do item below the form section. So let's create a new function display to do items. So as we have stored all the data in the to-do list array, so we can use the to-do list array to print the data. So for that, first do a validation that there is any items added to the array or not. If to-do list dot length greater than 0, we can show to-do list. Else we can show a custom message. We will show the to-do list in proper manner by using the HTML elements ULLI, so it looks proper for the user. So for that we will use ULLI structure like ULLI add some name like span and to do item name. Okay, of one another is for action, span for change the status, for the mark this is done, pending or remove. So this is the basic structure of the our to do items. So let's create three structure for our to do items. If to do list has some elements, so we can use for loop for I equal to 0, I less than to do list dot length, and increment the value of I plus plus. Here we are going to add all to do items in HTML element li. So first we create a few custom variables for proper formatting. Let's create variable container start equal to UL, because we are going to put all data in UL structure. So tag will be start with the UL. Second one is where list items. Let's create a blank variable because we are going to add it dynamically. Third one is where containers, and so we can close the UL tag. List item is blank, so we add the items by using the sign of plus equal to, so it will concatenate the tags. Let's use li and same way close the li. Now use the plus plus sign to concatenate more string and show the title of the to do list. So to do list I dot title. So it will show the title of the to do item within a li. Same way we just copy and paste here, and instead of the title we show the custom message no hooray no pending works to do. And after that we have print to the item to the web page. So for that we will create a section div and give the id equal to todo list. Now we will add the todo list within this element. So here document dot get element by id use dot inner html. Here we have to concatenate three different variables. First is start the ul elements, second is the content of the list items, and last one is close the ul tag. So const the content and let's save and check the preview. This is my to do. Now you can see it's not showing anything below it because we have created a function but didn't call to anywhere. So we will call display to do items here once a item has been added. Let's save and check the preview. My first to do items. Now you can see it show my first to do item, but it looks ugly and not proper. So I will use some boilerplate of the CSS code so it will looks proper. So friends, here I have added my CSS code for the to do list items. So it show a list in a proper manner. So first is to do list, and UL I have set the list type is none, so it will not show the bullets. And for the each li I have set some padding, some background color and border etc, and use two spans, one for the title and second for the action. So title will be display in the left side and action will be display on the right side. I have created one more class, done. So it will change the color of the li when we mark as a done. Let's save and check the preview. Now you can see it's look better. Now we have to add two buttons here. One is to mark as a done and second one is to remove the item. So first let's make a title in a span and assign the class equal to title and complete the tag. Now we have to add a one more span for the action. So here what we are going to do is complete this statement here and move the li to bottom side. So again use the same, so it will add more text to the variable. We can copy paste. Now here we are going to again a span tag, again close the span tag, make the code proper. Now we are going to add a anchor tag for the action. So list items plus equal to concatenate use a tag href. We are not going to redirect the page, so we are using JavaScript void 0. So it will do nothing. So when user click on the link, browser won't send it to anywhere. On click equal to again user single quote and call a function to do action. So here we have to first pass the position of the array. So to pass the array, first we have to complete the string by using double quote and add the plus sign, and we can pass I and again concatenate. So rest of things will be added to the function. Let me show you how the parameters has been passed to the function. Now you can see here is an anchor tag and this is a function on click do action. First is 0 and 0. 0 means position of the array and 0 means mark as a done. And for the delete, we have passed the position of the array 0. You can see it will show 0, 1 at all. So here first elements, second elements and second version. So we have to pass these two values as a dynamic. Let's mark as a done. Now you can see here it's become a 1 and 1 is to mark as a pending, and we can show the text mark pending. Also we have assigned a class done, so it will change the background color to green. So we have to pass these two values dynamically. Let's come to the our code part. So here do action, we have passed position of array element. Now we have to add comma, again double quote, two time plus sign, and here we have to pass a status need to set. So to make the code more proper, let's create a variable set status is equal to to do list and check the status of the existing element dot status. If it is a 0, we pass the 1 to make is a pending, else pass as a 0 to mark as a done. So here we have used short code of the if condition by using ternary operators. Now let's pass the set status here. Give a title. So title will be also dynamic. So we are using the same validation, like to-do list status equal to 0. So it means it is completed. So we can show mark pending, else we can show mark done. We can use the opposite side of the action. So for the done status we are showing mark pending, and for the pending we are showing mark as a done. So we can set proper action. Now close the anchor tag. So here first action is completed. Now copy and paste for the second action. One click, we can use to do delete. To delete we only need to pass the position of element within an array. So let's remove these things and let's use fixed tags delete, or we can better use X sign for the action. I have created a class equal to let's add some space by using nbsp, which create a single space on the web page. Now it's look better. Now we have to make the functionality of mark as a done or delete. So let's start with the to do action. Create a function here. We have to get two arguments. First one is number and second one is action to set. So again let's do some validation before do any action. If number not equal to null, we have execute this code. So to do list, to do list number, we are passing the element position. We need to change dot status equal to action. Here we are passing what the status we need to change. So we just assign to do list number and status value with the action passed through the function. As the data is updated, we need to update the list as well. So here again we will call the display to do items. Let's save, learn JavaScript, do more practice. Okay, let's mark first one is learn JavaScript, mark as a done. Now you can see it's mark as a done and showing the label mark pending. But it is hard to find which is completed and which is done. So we are going to change the background color with the green. So let's add a class done to the li tag, which is marked as a completed. So let's come to display to do items. Here let's create a new variable where set class is equal to. So let's copy the same. So if status is 0, it means it is completed. We have assigned a class done, else we assign a class pending and assign a class to the li. Class equal to single quote. As the value is passing from the variable, first we need to complete the string and add plus sign, again plus sign to continue the rest of string. So it will check the status of the each elements and assign the class accordingly. So status equal to, if status equal to 0, it means it set the class done, otherwise it add the class pending. So for done, we have added a background color green. Before preview, let's remove the alert message because we are going to display below the form, so it is not necessary now. Learn JavaScript, do more practice, do testing. Okay, let's mark first as a done. Now you can see it's changed the color because it's assigned a done class, and done class has a background color. You can use any color here. You can mark second one is also done. Let's move with the functionality of remove. For remove, we have call a function to do delete. So let's create a function and get the value of arguments. Again, we can validate the value before doing any action. So if number not equal to null, we can also add and number greater than 0 greater than equal to 0, because array start with the 0, so it may be possible that 0 will be passed as a arguments. So only that case we run our code. So here we are using the splice. So to do list dot splice and give the position of the elements which needs to remove, like number, and here we are going to pass 1 because only one element needs to remove. So again let's copy and update the result by calling the function display to do items. Learn JavaScript, do more practice, do. Now let's mark first one as a done and try to delete. Now you can see first one is deleted. Now let's do with the last one, mark as done, delete. Now only one is there, do more practice. Let's mark as a done and remove it. Now you can see the custom message is showing no pending words to do. So friends, I hope this small to do list application is useful to you. Here I want to give you an exercise to create the same to do list application by using DOMs like create elements, text node, using inner HTML, style properties, etc.